Hello, my fellow YouTubers. Let's walk into the gate of learning. I want to show off my little, can't call it a mini, because it's the same diameter size as Leedskalnin's wheel. I'm just doing two courses, and I got it sitting on this little fan motor. Fan motor ain't for nothing, not to turn it or nothing. It's just using it to as a pedestal, pretty much. The interesting thing about this build is through the course of building this, the full version, five magnets high, so many times, over 100 times. I finally, this time, building this one about maybe 10 times over, I realized a couple pointers that I probably should have paid attention to a long time ago, is the strength of these magnets and what makes them stronger and what makes them weaker. And I got this big old flywheel plate on the bottom there. And I was just sitting the magnets on that plate with no insulation in between it. And kept doing it, never really tested it for anything. This time I decided to test it if the magnets were stronger, if there was more metal there, doesn't make the magnets stronger if the magnet was sitting on the plate. So I did some tests there, and I would check the strength of the magnet and before it's on the metal. Then I check the strength of the magnet when it's on the metal. I noticed when it's on the metal, it's weaker. I also noticed that on these magnets that it's the front portion that is, like, I would call it the hot zone, meaning like if the metal is anywhere from that portion on up, it's going to absorb the magnetism. And like this one right here is just sitting on top of it. So this metal ring here now temporarily is stuck. Like it's stuck to the magnets. It's got a grip of that piece there. You know, so you can see my finger lifting it up. So it won't come up. So that's not good. But this will be insulated with this rubber just as well as the bottom. And also this is insulated. And then we're going to connect the top ring, the clover, to one of these uprights in four places to pull down the section. One, it helps me level these this way. But secondly, I want the bottom section to be grounded. And I want the top clover section to be grounded. And I want this in free space, and I want this in free space. And the two free spaces here, one of these will be picking up a positive, and one would be picking up a negative charge. So it'll be two isolated charges. So that's where the positive and negative is able to move up from. Now, on top of that, I want to put, through building so many units, I've never sold one. So if anybody's interested in something like this, just give me a damn email. Could be interested in making some. So anyway, what I've realized is I would put a coil inside the center. You know, I would just pick, let me see, something like 18 gauge or even 16 gauge, and I would put it in the center. And when I fire that up and tap it, I realized that it affected the strength of these magnets out here. So, and this is the neutral area, which is not affected by the hot area. The hot area seems to be where all the magic is happening. Up from a certain point of the metal to the back, because it's jointed, seems to be inactive in a sense. But when you have electromagnetic field on the backside of the iron reacts to that electromagnetic field. So what I was thinking about is putting a coil in here about the same height and have it real wide, and have the core of the iron block, which is right there, the core of the iron block becomes the grounded device, which is connected to this flywheel. So that flywheel will be connected to the block itself. And then on top of that, what I believe, which I'm going to prove to you guys somehow, is we're going to take ground and we're going to add a little Tesla-esque grounding system to Ed's pipe. So basically, one thing I want to bring out there that I've learned some information on a while back is that Ed's water well, is a circulating well, and he knows where it runs from underneath his property, and it runs underneath his workshop, for one. Two is Tesla would have a water system running underneath his Wardenclyffe and on up through the center of Wardenclyffe on over into the capacitor, about a third way up into the capacitor, the top load of his Wardenclyffe tower, and back down and circled it a pup and went back on top. Now, I did read quite a few of his patents. He got over 300 patents. If you guys should do research, if you want to learn on Tesla, the patent 94, one I'm referencing to now is a patent that he has for wireless system, and the system also includes some grounding verbiage in there. And one thing that I've seen on one of Tesla's patents is, I forget which number it is, that he's talking about a liquid nitrogen. So he's talking about a superconductor situation underground. So that's, I believe, Ed Leedskalnin was reading a lot about Tesla, because when I was at Coral Castle quite a few times, I would go back in the gift shop and just look at the books that they gathered up, that they gathered that was up in Ed's reading, or Ed's living quarters. So you could see what books he was, what knowledge he was reading. You could just imagine him reading about Tesla and just doing a lot of research. And if you start looking into what Ed was interested in and what he talked about, you could definitely see he was into radio, he was into transfer signals. There's accounts to where the Navy came to his place, because there's a, down at Key West, there's a naval station, and he was interfering. They were picking up signals that he was putting out, and they were tracking the signals, tracing the signals back down. They were going to Ed Leedskalnin's place, and that's where the local sheriff had to vouch that Ed Leedskalnin was not a Nazi. So, going back to the pipe, if you think about the pipe, why would you have the pipe? And why would the pipe come up over and come have like some kind of hook with chains that are all connected to this ground above this wheel? It makes no sense, especially in the picture. But what does make sense is if you use the ground as a positive and negative, and you tease the ground with high potential, and you have to get into the stuff that I've been learning about for the last 5 years, which is not one particular thing, not two, not 10, not 20, but it's a wide, broad range, because the more you know, the less you know, because there's so much more to learn. So what the reaction from the ground through many experiments and probably a lot that I have on YouTube, but a lot more that's not on YouTube, that how the ground reacts and why we only get a volt, if that, maybe a couple out of the ground. And it's not really what you think, how you could pull energy out of the ground, because the ground is an absorption mode. And you got to look at how would you pull ground out of something that's an absorption, when in reality, if you go to nature, you'll see that a cloud brings electrostatic over the ground at a certain distance, and then the ground reacts. All of a sudden, the ground will, if the bottom of the cloud is positive, the ground now becomes negative or attractive, and it pushes all the positive deeper down in the ground. So it's that ground. So that's what we're going to have to go after. That's what Leedskalnin discovered. And that's probably why the patent office would, people came in there, thugs, and sent people in there. And they first send the government in, the patent office people, the government to take what he had, and he wouldn't give it to them. So later on, thugs came in and beat him down to life. So beat him to almost where he wasn't alive. So that makes sense. So I believe that if you take simple, let's go over here. If you take simple, a start, a spark aerator, this wasn't made to go fast. So we're not talking, the way Ed set this up, it's not a fast machine. So we're looking to put some type of Schumann earth resonant frequency balanced Tesco-like, in a sense of harmonics, to the wavelength that's going by this pipe every time. So many times right now, there's a wave that's going through my whole garage. We're in ether, plus we're in airspace. So you got all this going by. So there's something right now taking whatever energy is in there, and that pipe is about 8 feet deep, 6 feet deep. So that energy is just moving up and down. And it's a shitty-ass conductor. Even though I have a copper pipe next to it, which makes it a better than a shitty conductor, but on the side here, I got a pipe right here. It's steel with copper. Tesla figured out that the ground needs a superconductor buried deep inside the ground and below the affected area. That's where you went 150 feet. The affected area from the clouds, he figured out that was approximately 100 to 150 feet. So the upper surface of the crust of the earth is affected by the clouds, and it's because of electrostatics. And that's why I mess with these electrostatics with you guys, and I hope you enjoy all these little electrostatic experiments are cool, because it ain't just about, I'm not trying to run my motor of the electrostatic and think I'm going to run something significant. But that's not the intention. The intention is controlling different parts of the energies that we come across when we're dealing with high voltage. Like this whole setup here. I love this. NST, 15,000 volts, 60 milliamp. I got another one. I haven't taken it out of the box still. You know, I was going to put them together, and then I got same 15,000 volts, but I got 120 milliamps. I like to do three or four of them just to push. Forget about these bottles. These bottles are great. Great for 15,000 volts. I could blow them up if I spread out the spark gap, but that's a given. I need some capacitors that are pulse 20,000 volt capacitors, so I can have a range off the 15,000 to 20 to be a cushion, so I don't blow those guys up. But I need a good amount of capacitance. And what I want to do is build that capacitance up, not in the Tesla, but into Ed's thing. It's the capacitance on this pipe that's going to make this pipe react just like a cloud is over the top of the damn